I'm going to share some good news that happened with me that involved, it's a testimony, but it's also good news because although there wasn't necessarily a result from it, but the seed had been planted. And I've got a scripture that was also laid on my heart that related to the subject. And basically what happened, one day, the video that you saw, the last one, with me doing the glow stick robot. On the way to that practice, and on the bus, sitting there, quite a long journey to Myers, I think it's about half an hour on the bus that I was on. And this guy got on the bus, sat at the back of the bus, and just sitting there, just going through the journey, and then just randomly just, had this well psychology, and I was like, P-S. And it was just like that, and I eventually managed to spell it off the top of my head. Anybody reach out to us. So, I was just thinking there, this guy's kind of weird. And then he just started talking about women and how you're ready to hang yourself for your wife and you're ready to shoot yourself in your head and you're willing to do this, that, and the other. I'm like, okay, this guy's definitely something wrong with this guy. And I was like, okay, I'm just going to skip talking a little bit. And it was like, sitting there, and then I was just thinking to myself, Lord, what do I say to this guy? Because this guy, obviously, I need to say something to him. I can't just sit here and let him, yeah, give me all of this. And I thought the next thing he's going to do is attack me. Women are terrible. So I was like, okay. And I was like, do you believe in God? And he was like, I used to. And I was like, okay, why used to? He was like, oh, because my brother's dead. My sister's dead. My mum and dad are dead. My wife's planning to leave me. My wife thinks I'm a nut job. My wife thinks I'm this, that, and the other. And I was like, okay. My brother hung himself in front of me. My sister got in a car crash. I was in the car. Why did she have to die? What did they do wrong? What have I done wrong to deserve all of this pain, all of this? What have I ever done to anybody? And I was like, sometimes you don't have to do anything to anybody. But what you go through is what the Lord wants you to be built up as. Like, you will go through more circumstances than other people will, but that will just shape who you are. And when you do eventually, or if you do come to Christ, it's going to build you up. Because he would have some good news. If he came to Christ, he would be the good news. He would be some good news. Imagine he came here and he found Christ. When he stood in front of his church and told people what he'd gone through, the sort of thing he witnessed, trust me, people would be blessed. People would be touched, because if you get to a certain place where you've been through so much and you come to Christ, you are going to be a blessed person in God, and God has got his hand on his shoulder. And I was just talking to him, trying to encourage him. And when somebody's got himself into that much pain and into that much strife that they just blame it on something, when somebody's gone through that much, when they blame it on something, they don't let go of it. But I know my God, I know that my God can bring the good news to him. And what I was saying when I started, although he more or less threw what I was saying back in his face, in my face, the seed has been sown in him. So he can never say that he didn't have that opportunity. He's still got it, that's the thing. Like, sometimes it doesn't happen immediately, it won't, just because of the situation. But I believe that my God will. And the scripture that I had was taken from Mark 5, verse 24 to 36. I'll just go over it quickly. And it starts with the woman with the issue of blood, and then it goes on to the man whose daughter died, or so forth, they thought that died. So Jesus went with him, and a great multitude followed with him and thronged him. Now a certain woman had a flow of blood for 12 years, and had suffered many things from many physicians. She had spent all that she had and was no better, but rather grew worse. When she heard about Jesus, she came behind him in the crowd and touched his garment. And she said, if only I may touch his clothes, I shall be made well. Immediately the fountain of her blood was dried up, and she felt in her body that she was healed of the affliction. And Jesus, immediately knowing in himself that power had gone out of him, turned around in the crowd and said, who touched my clothes? But his disciples said to him, you see the multitude thronging you, and you say, who touched me? And he looked around to see her, who had done this thing. But the woman, fearing and trembling, knowing what had happened to her, came and fell down before him and told him the whole truth. And he said to her, "Daughter, your faith has made you well. Go in peace and be healed of your affliction." While he was still speaking, some came from the wall out of the synagogue's house who said, "Your daughter is dead. Why trouble the teacher any further?" As soon as Jesus heard the words that were spoken, he said to the ruler of the synagogue, "Do not be afraid, only believe." Now that verse, verse 36, that phrase that Jesus said, "Do not be afraid, only believe," has brought me through so much. When I was saying about my good news about me getting into university, that was one of the verses that the Lord laid on my spirit, "Do not be afraid, only believe." Now I know that many of us go through situations and hard times, but do not be afraid, only believe. When you need something, when you're struggling to look at Mark 5 from 24 to 36, just look at it, meditate on it, and just know that God is able. The next song that we're about to do is "It's Time Now."